crazy? You can't make a movie without a script.
Yeah, I know that, but this guy Morris, he's got the whole script in his head. He's got some great ideas, and look, I don't know why, Jan, but I believe in this guy.
No, my psychic warned me about this.
What did I say about those stupid phone calls?
They're not stupid. She gives me good advice, and she told me something like this would happen.
Something like what?
Well, that my significant other was gonna meet someone and all hell was gonna break loose.
Give me that. Hello?
Hey, man, it's me, bro.
Hey, what's up? You okay?
Well...
What is it? What's going on?
Ivan's in jail, man. Can you give me a ride to bail him out?
Sure.
Thanks, man.
Okay. I gotta go, babe.
Let me guess. It was Morris, right?
Yeah, his roommate's in jail.
That's wonderful. So why do you have to go?
Morris just needs a ride to bail him out.
Whatever.
Hey, wake up.
Hey.
Where's the wagon?
Ivan said he was getting some food.
What's this shit? Oh, shit!
What?
No fucking way!
What, man?
Fucking read that! Ah!
Jesus freaking Christ, I can't fucking believe that guy! Ah!
Son of a bitch! No, you fucking Ivan! What the fucking shit, son? What the fuck? Ivan!
You know how long I've known Ivan, man? A long, long time, and now he wakes up and takes my movie away from me!
Screw the movie! The asshole took my car!
Fuck your car, what about my movie?
What movie? There's no script, there's no money. Do you even know how to make a movie, write a script? You loser, Jan told me this was gonna happen, and I should've listened to her.
You should've listened to Jan. You should've listened to your girlfriend. I know nothing about the film industry. Oh, stupid. I'm not Dom DeLuise on a good fucking
cool,
day.
Yeah. When you write something, I'll believe you're a fucking writer. Loser.
Okay, Mr. Non-working studying actor.
Oh, that's fucking cool.
Yeah,
what,
is that cooler?
I don't know, man. I've never felt like that. I've never played like that. It was amazing. I know, but I don't think running away is a good idea. I'm not going back in there. You can't beat these sons of bitches.
You can beat them.
It's a rigged game.
It's a rigged game if you run away. They automatically win that way.
I wouldn't do it. I wouldn't do it if I were you. If you're gonna go, I'd go now. He'll be up anytime. I'll cover for you as long as I can. You got bucks?
Yeah, I got some.
I'm gonna miss you, man.
Same.
All right, you know where to get me. You need me.
Beautiful, isn't she?
Most beautiful girl I ever saw.
Only girl you ever saw.
Shut up or I'll kick your little butt.
Try it, Blimpo.
I'm gonna nail her.
What?
I'm gonna light up Benedict's precious little daughter like a pinball machine.
What do you mean you're gonna nail her?
What do you mean? What do I mean?
Die?
What do you think I mean?
Yeah, sure you are.
You wanna bet? Huh? Come on, you boys must have a little chore allowance saved up. Put your money where your big mouth is.
Okay. I'll bet.
Me too.
How much? Good. $2?
Shut up, you don't have
$2. Wait a second. I don't think that we should bet about something like this.
What's the matter? Chicken?
No, I'm not chicken. I just don't
think...
Hey, you shut up. You what? It's not right. I she's a nice girl.
So marry her.
Are you kidding me? Look at her sitting back there. That's Benedict's little pride and joy. This'll teach him. All right, fine. You don't want in? No problem. How about the rest of you guys?
I'm in.
Yeah.
Oh, geez.
Sarah. Sarah, I'm sorry about last night. About the bed and everything. I got no excuses. Except that you scared me. I mean, that first day you showed up, I remember thinking, this is the kind of girl that would never want to have anything to do with me. So I guess I must have known already that I liked you. And it scared me.
You were right about the picture. Came with the wallet. It just looked like the kind of folks a guy should have, and I just sort of adopted them.
So who were your parents?
Who were my parents? Father was a wildcatter, and my mother was a waitress, or maybe she was a sales girl and he was in the service. Or maybe they were just two teenagers who met behind a bar.
Man, it's such a dive, you know?
Yeah, it's got that beat-up jazz look.
I will bet you that Kerouac hung out here, you know? He's written all over this place.
I wouldn't be surprised. He was such a drunk. Probably weren't many bars in the city he wasn't in.
Yeah, but this place in particular, I can feel that drunk poetry vibe, you know?
Man.
Excuse me, sir. How you doing? Are you using that ashtray? Have you you been coming here for a long time? I was wondering like how long you've been coming here, you know. What I really wanted to know was actually how long has this place been here? Like when did it open?
56.
1956. Cool.
I thought maybe turn of the century, something like that.
No, me. I've been coming here since 1956. I don't know how old this place is. It's very old. From before my time.
Cool. we go to school at NYU and live at the dorms.
NYU?
Yeah.
College boys. Now, what are you studying? To be bankers?
No, film.
Oh, film?
Yeah.
What kind of jobs can you get from film? You run a one-hour photo?
No, we make movies.
So you're gonna be movie stars, huh? Like Victor Mature?
No, directors.